I would say I first heard of you had a political science class at VCU, and my teacher, she was a feminist, she was kind of gearing the class towards a feminist viewpoint of things. She always kind of highlighted like a white man in her class, and then she once mentioned your name in an ill way manner. I was like, well, who is this? Yeah.
So sorry.
So I was like looking into this because we had an argument about gender pay gap, and she thought it was real, and she brought you up, I guess, in that conversation. And so in my course, like reading more into it, or come across your work, it's like, oh my God, this is really weird. Feminist who kind of, I would say, knows these arguments, right? And not trying to pass an agenda. I said, how would you say you got yourself into this area of interest?
Well, I originally got my PhD in philosophy and taught philosophy. And that's a field where you learn to argue and reason and question basic assumptions. And I started doing that fairly early on in my career with feminist theory, because it seemed to me just to be a question begging and full of fallacies. And I thought that by pointing those out, that would be enough. Naively, I thought just people will come to their senses and see this isn't reasonable and their premises are false. And it didn't quite work out that way. But to answer your question, it was more my training as a philosopher.
I love that. And like, it's weird because you think like, you're like, this is so obvious. Why can't you see what I'm seeing?
Yeah, it's that you would have a professor that just wants to resist viewpoints without engaging with them. She didn't really engage with me or with you. She just said, oh, you know, a bad person. Stop this conversation.
Right. We had a thing where like, so we need to talk after class. And she said, well, like, I need to stop interrupting because I'm trying to show them I have the authority. It's like, I'm fine, but nowhere in the political class they say this will be a feminist, you know, version of viewpoint of like history. I would say, you know, today was the Women's March today. Did you see any of that?
The march was just torn apart through identity politics and unfortunately some anti-Semitism in the leadership, in the sense that they would not repudiate Louis Farrakhan, who was called, I am Jewish. But even if you're not Jewish, you don't want to hear Jewish people called termites and evil and, you know, the conspiracy theories. And how could the Women's March, which was supposed to be about humane values and basic democratic, you know, democratic virtues, how could that become captive to hardline, you know, sort of political extremists? And I do think it comes out of the politics in the university that's dysfunctional right now.
Right, exactly. You have a great website, I guess, in terms of like facts.
I have the Factual Feminist and my podcast, The Femsplainers. So check us out.
Yeah, I love that. I would say my last question would be in terms of like recently the Gillette commercial came out. And what are your thoughts or opinion towards that? Did you find it to be an attack on masculinity?
I just thought that it seemed to be agenda driven, and that you would not see an ad like that for any other group except men.
Right.
You know, where they sort of say all the bad things you do and you can be better. You know, will they do that for women? I don't think so.
Right, exactly. I guess one last question would be, like, how would you define feminist? Because you identify as a feminist. And I think that's, like, here at, a libertarian place. Like the only early person I know who does call it...
lots of libertarian feminists, but...
Like Wendy McRae, I think, someone else. Right.
Wendy McRae, Kathy Young, Deirdre McCloskey, my favorite libertarian and feminist. So there are lots of libertarian feminists, but unfortunately... The theories of libertarian feminism are really not part of the curriculum, and libertarian women are just not invited to the table.
Right. Would you say in the push of like equality that at least here in the United States is kind of accomplished or pushed forward towards a good area?
Yes, I think the basic battles have been fought and won. Now, it's not that women don't have problems.
Right.
Of course they do. So do men. And there's still some unfinished, you know, struggles. But overall, if you look at men and women in the United States, it would be hard to say who's worse off. Both have benefits and burdens. It's a complicated mix of benefits and burdens. So what we probably need is egalitarianism and a feminism or an egalitarianism that sees men and women as partners, we're in this together. We're not two separate teams. It's not a zero-sum game. So that's more what I'm hoping feminism will find its way. It once was more like that, and there was concern for men, but now it's almost devolving into a kind of female chauvinism. I didn't like male chauvinism, but I don't think female chauvinism is the answer. I think mutual respect between men and women is where we should go.